Okay, so today I'm going to be teaching you about factorials and what a factorial is. So a factorial is the product of an integer and all the integers below it. So factorial 4 would be 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which equals 24. So factorials can be used to solve probability problems like this one. So if we had a table, and it had 3 seats. We'll label those seats 1, 2, and 3. There's 3 people, so A, B, C, and A, person A, B, and C, we're all looking for places to sit. How many different combinations or scenarios would there be? So to solve this, we could write it out, just keep making different combinations. This, we could have A here, B here, C there, we could have A at the top, B here, and then C there. Those are just 2 different combinations, so there could be many more. So another way to find this, so we had seat 1. So for seat 1, we could have A in the first seat, and then we'll leave 2 and 3 blank, B in the first seat, well, 2 and 3 blank. We can have C in the first seat. And we can leave 2 and 3 blank again. And then for seat 2, we could have for A, we could A and then B. Third one blank, A and C. Third one blank. So those are 2 combinations for seat A. We'll do the same for B and C. C, A. So we have combinations for seats 1 and 2. So for seats 3, so for seat 1, 2, and 3 all put together. A, B, and then the only person left would be C. A, C, B. B, C, A. B, A, C. C, A, B. C, B, A. So those are the 6 combinations. So that would be one way to find it. That is also time consuming. So if we look at this, this would be factorial 3. But if we were to draw another blank, so 1, 2, 3. So for seat 1, up top we had 3 combinations. So we'll put a 3 here. For seat 2, you can see that there is 2 options per seat. So for A, there's 2 more combinations there could be, same with B and C. Put 2 here. And then for the third seat, there's only 1 person left to be seated, so we can put a 1 here. So 3 factorial equals 6. So that is another way to find the scenario. The basic factorial formula is N. N factorial would be N times N minus 1, then times N minus 2, and now just keep going until you get to 1, basically. So let's say, let's plug 3 for N, so that would be 3 times, so 3 minus 1. So that would be 3, and 3 minus 1 is 2, 3 minus 2 is 1. So that would be it, and that would equal 6. That's basically what you do. So obviously, 3 factorial equals 3 times 2 times 1, 2 factorial equals 2 times 1, 1 factorial equals 1. If we have 0 factorial, what would it be? So if we look at the pattern, some people might think, oh, it's 1. But that's actually not the case. 0 factorial is 1. Okay, so if we want to solve more complex factorial problems, like we had factorial 6 over factorial 4. So factorial 4 equals 24, because 4 times 3 is 12, times 2 is 24, times 1 is still 24. So we can do 24, and then factorial 6 would be 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which would equal 30 times 4 is 120, times 3 is 360, times 2 is 720. So that'd be 720. So we could do 720 divided by 24, which would be 30, I believe. Yes, 30. But there's an easier way to do this, because that's a lot of math. It's really not. There's an easier way. So we did, let's just take this, and we took put it over 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is factorial 4. We can cancel out 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, both sides. We can just do 6 times 5, which would be 30. So this would equal 30. We can also do it with harder problems, like if we did factorial 100 over factorial 95, because that would equal, we would have 100 times 98 times 97 times 95, or 96, and then that dot 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 would just like trail off, because that would cancel out, because the factorial is 95 over the factorial of 95. So from 95 on from 100 would just cancel out. So we would just have to do this times each other to get the answer. So here we have another complex factorial problem, and we have factorial 15 minus factorial 14 over factorial 8 minus factorial 7, and that equals to 15 parentheses factorial 14 minus factorial 14 over 8 parentheses factorial 7 minus factorial 7. And then you can think of 14 factorial 15 parentheses factorial 14 minus factorial 14 as if you're subtracting an x value from an x from a 15 x value, so it can equal 15x minus x will give you 14x, and that is why down here we start at 14 instead of 15, because the 15 kind of gets subtracted, and then you're left with 14 times 13 times 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times factorial 7, because from that point on it's just like the same, and over factorial 7, and that cancels out. So you're left with just 14 times 13 times 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 times 8. And then you have to multiply that by 2, because up here, as you can see, factorial 14 over factorial 7 equals 2. So therefore, you have to multiply it by 2, and you get 34,594,560. Okay, we can edit that part out. I'm just gonna say that over again. Actually, hold on, wait. What do I say? Like, how do I start off the video?
N times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 4 times 3 times 2 times
5.
Oh.
Okay, I guess we're starting over.
Factorial 15 minus factorial 14 over factorial 8 minus factorial 7. And this just equals 15 parentheses.
We good, we good, we good.